As a sailor, we tend to be in areas without humans. For me, that's all I need. What I like about sailing is it's like really sustainable traveling. You depend on the nature 100%. I love it. I mean, I get seasick all the time, but I still love it because you just feel so attached to the environment. I'm Niklas. I'm a travel photographer and I'm a sailor and also an adventurer. When Joscha asked me, okay, Niklas, why do you want to go to Spitzbergen? I said, it's on the way. So, of course, it's not just on the way. I mean, it's probably the most northern island you can sail to, and it's the most northern capital. What are the things I need for travel? Well, I would say, in my case, of course, my camera. This is like the basic setup. I mean, I'm a gear geek, so I really love cameras and lenses and from different brands. And on the other hand, when I'm working, I just don't think about my camera anymore. It's just a tool. On a boat, you have to fix everything all the time. So everything breaks because salt water, harsh conditions. This is a good thing with tool watches compared to like this new kind of smartwatches and digital watches. You just throw them away because nobody, I can't fix them. But like a tool watch, like a mechanical watch, you can fix. And on a boat, you have to fix everything yourself too. So I think there is a similarity, I would say. I think the tool watch plays one part in the story, but the people behind the watch company play the other part. When I contacted Fortis, they were so directly, so open-minded. We have the same ideas about traveling, about sustainability, about adventures. And I have so many partnerships with different brands and stuff like that. And they are very often just very, very short because they just want free photos. But I'm more looking for like long-term relationships, kind of. When you approach an adventure, the most important thing is the attitude, because everything else you can train for it, you can buy the stuff, but you need the right mindset, especially when you go on really hard expeditions. If you have the best clothing, it doesn't really matter if you kill yourself after 3 weeks on the ice, for example. I think you have to be a satisfied and happy person. So that's like the base level you need, especially when you're in a group. I mean, I'm always traveling with Joscha, with my captain. The first time we met, we are like kind of soul brothers. I don't know, we completely different people. He's an engineer, I'm an artist, photographer. But it's always a good time with us, I would say.
Ja, wie soll man das nennen? Hier die Deckblende oder sowas? Keine Ahnung.
Schanzkleid.
Wie?
Das Schanzkleid.
Das Schanzkleid abgenommen.
Und dann die noch Mr. Halfbeard.
So when we sailed to Greenland, there was one moment when we were in the Prince Christian Sound. It's like really the southern tip of Greenland. And there's one huge glacier. And of course I always had this shot in my mind, like this Instagram is shot, this David versus Goliath. Yeah, we have the small boat and the massive glacier. I don't know, I can't tell much about the photo because it was a beautiful moment, of course. But what I can tell you about the photo, and that is like the sad fact about the photo, when we sailed to this glacier again on the way back to Germany, and it was so small, you could literally see climate change in one photo. That's basically my take from this whole expedition to Greenland. I take so many photos. It's a digital world. We just press the button and brrr, so, but the moment where you just stop and breathe for a second, I would say this is like the probably the best photo. The photo with your mind.